I am so thankful. I am so thankful the blood is sufficient, and that from day to day, from circumstance to circumstance, from time in the beginning and until the time ends and the clocks turn no more, that his blood remains sufficient for me. I am so thankful it doesn't run out. I am so thankful it doesn't leave me when I am put in the darkest, the most alone places of my life. I am so thankful that it stands still on the ground when I'm lifting my hands to praise him for all that he has done. I am so thankful for God. I am so thankful for the sufficiency he brings in my life. And though some days I wake up and it's not the best of days, and the devil jumps on me and he pulls me down time and time again, that I can cling to a promise that my God remains sufficient for me.
Yeah. Amen.
There is nothing that can separate you from the love of God except yourself. Your mind becomes the devil's playground of defeat when you allow it to. And until you cling to the promise that my God will be sufficient despite my circumstances, he will be sufficient, he will pull through, he will bring me through the fire again.
Amen.
You will remain in defeat in your mind, and the devil will cling to you and pull you down time and time again. Every day is a battleground. Every day approaches with these challenges, puts us in this rat race that we have to run, and we have to make money, and we have to go to jobs, and we have to take care of kids, and we have to come home and do it all over again, time and time and time again. Until we stop and say, God, what am I doing for you today? Who can I impact? What lost soul is going to come in front of my eyes? How can I change the path and the final destination of somebody I'm going to encounter today? When you start thinking like that, the money and the job and the kids, that all seems to start to crumble, because your mind gets set on a final destination of eternity, and you get out of your box of circumstances for this tiny little string on your life that exists for now. He is sufficient, and he will remain sufficient. But until we let go of our caged concepts, we will not find that peace. You will not find that consistency. You cannot do this life on your own, no matter how much you think you can handle. You cannot walk this life alone and find peace and joy and comfort. He is the only one that can bring about peace, joy, and comfort in the world we live in today. God, I want you to consume this room. I want you to come, and I want your spirit to just lay down on these people that are here today. I want us to stop in our minds, and I want us to thank God of where our priorities stand. Do we live every day for you? Or do we live for a paycheck or a praise from humans, dear God, that we encounter? What are we living for, dear God? If our priorities are out of line and we're missing it, dear God, convict these hearts today. Call them to a higher stance, dear God, that we may know your true sufficiency in our lives. Take us out of our caged circumstances and help us to see, dear God, there is an eternal value in each soul that is in this room. There's an eternal value in each soul that walks in and out of McDonald's in MacArthur, Ohio. There's an eternal value in each soul in this community, dear God. And until we grasp the true calling, dear God, of being a higher called people, dear Jesus, to your purpose, convict our hearts. Let us not sleep at night until our priorities are in line. Let us not speak, dear Jesus, of what you want, dear God, until we we might know you. Know your sufficient power. Know your cleansing blood. Know your ever presence, dear Jesus, that you can bring to our lives. Convict our hearts. There's somebody, dear Jesus, that does not know you today. I ask that you would pour your love on their life right now. That you would just consume them with your presence and prove your existence, dear Jesus, in this moment. Dear God, we are so thankful for who you are. And we ask, dear God, if there's someone in this room, that you would just call them, dear God, with your love. Call them, dear God, with your consistency. So they might come to know you in a personal way. Thank you for all you're going to do, dear Jesus. Thank you for all that you've done. And thank you for never leaving us. May we continue to worship the one and only name that can save.